My name is Carly Page. I am a third-year PhD student in the Molecular Microbiology and Immunology program. I thought the core course was a really great idea. I think it kind of brings everyone together as a program. The programs are very small, but when you put everybody in one group, you have a chance to meet people with different backgrounds and working on different things. I also just really like the vibe of the program. I think we have a very good balance of work and life, and that it's not too much fun, but there's also an understanding that you do have a life outside of the lab, so that was important to me. At a lot of schools, in your first year, you take molecular biology, biochemistry, genetics, all as individual courses, but at Maryland, it is integrated into one course that is very intensive and takes place over the first semester that you're here. It benefits everybody in that you all come from very different backgrounds, and that even if you think you know things, sometimes you get here and you're like, oh, that's like a different way of learning. I also think once you're in graduate school, everything is taught from a different angle, and that everything is problem-based and you're looking at a lot more data. It's not just facts thrown at you. So it teaches you to think and kind of gets you into that mindset very early on. I actually got interested in immunology because my sister, who's 2 years older than I am, developed an autoimmune disease when we were in middle school. So I think seeing her develop that made me kind of start to think about different ways that maybe we could better understand how the immune system works. So I work on SARS pathogenesis, and I specifically work on the role of STAT1 signaling in the host response to SARS infection. They found following the SARS outbreak is that there is people developing what's called fibrotic-like disease, and that is kind of a hardening of the lung tissue, so you don't have air exchange, so you're not breathing as well. And so we're working on one little molecule that seems to play a key role in how that develops after you recover from infection. We're looking at it more from the angle of how we can better understand pulmonary fibrosis, which is a disease that is 100% fatal. Everybody who gets pulmonary fibrosis will eventually pass from the disease. So what we're hoping to understand is how, if we can find a way to regulate the immune system better, that we can stop the disease from progressing and from even beginning.